Hey everyone, in this numerical method video, we are going to be solving the following system of equations using Gauss elimination with partial pivoting. So, if you missed my previous videos on Gauss elimination or partial pivoting, check out the videos linked in the description down below and then come back to this video. So, let's get right into this example. The first thing we are going to do is convert this system of equations into an augmented matrix, as it makes it less cumbersome and makes solving our matrix much cleaner. The matrix will look like this once augmented. To solve this problem using Gauss elimination, we're going to follow this procedure. Firstly, we'll transform all the elements that are pink here to zero, and then we will use backward substitution to work back and solve for all of our variables. Then, lastly, we'll validate our variables are correct by proving that they do solve our system of linear equations. But how do we reduce all the pink elements to zero? Especially since we are asked to use partial pivoting. Well, here's the procedure to complete step one of our process. Every iteration that we complete, we will begin by first checking if a partial pivot is necessary. If so, we will perform the partial pivot. If not, then we skip this step and then use our scaling factor to transform all of the pink elements to zero. Now, we are ready to begin our work. As stated above, the first order of business here is to check if a partial pivot is necessary. As stated in the previous video, we work from left to right down our main diagonal. Therefore, we first focus on column 1. To check if partial pivot is going to be necessary, we need to look in the first column and see if an absolute of any elements are larger than our 2 here. That is currently our main diagonal, or our pivot element. As you can see, the absolute value of 15 is larger than 2 or 1. Therefore, partial pivoting tells us to swap these two rows. And we now have the following augmented matrix. Now we just advance ahead using our typical Gauss elimination. So we have element row 1, column 1, minus our row 2 scaling factor, which will be 2 over 15, times our row 2, column 1 element. And then we find the row 3 scaling factor equation the same way. Now I'm just going to show the calculations here and color code them to the corresponding variable. Now, to fully eliminate truncation error, we should just leave our fractions like so. However, with partial pivoting, we are minimizing truncation error by using a larger number in our scaling factor denominator, so it is slightly less important, depending on your application. At the end of the video, I will show the solution to this matrix with and without using fractions. So, after our first Gauss elimination step, we are left with the following augmented matrix. Now, we need to check if partial pivoting is necessary again for row 2. So, looking at our main diagonal and down, we can see that the absolute of 2.866 is larger than the absolute of 0.733. Therefore, we use partial pivoting and swap rows 2 and 3. This leaves us with the following augmented matrix. Repeating the calculations we did above, we can convert the remaining pink elements to 0 and fully solve our matrix. Therefore, we have row 3 minus our scaling factor, which is 0.733, over 2.866 times row 2. After completing these calculations here, you can see that we are left with the following matrix. Additionally, you will notice that we have all of our pink elements to 0, as we said we wanted earlier. Therefore, we are now ready to begin backward substitution and solve these three equations. We begin with our last row, and we can solve for z, which is 3.157. Then, using z, we can plug it into equation 2 and solve for y. Y is equal to minus 0.1018. And lastly, using y and z, we can solve for our first equation here, which is x, which works out to 0.3469. Lastly, we stated earlier that we can validate our results by plugging these variables into our original equations. So that is easy enough, and we can validate your answers with the ones I just presented here. I hope that this video helped your understanding of how to complete a Gauss elimination problem with partial pivoting. If you enjoyed, please like, subscribe, and consider checking out our YouTube memberships by clicking that join button down below. However, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns about the information I provided in this video, please leave a comment down below and I will do my best to address your concerns.